Hi everybody, it's Kathy Zilski. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today I have a fun birthday card project to share featuring a really gorgeous filigree message circle from Simon Says Stamp, some simple ink blending, and a fabulous birthday sentiment. So let's jump in and take a look at the products. This card is using the brand new filigree message circle, and what is so cool about this die is that it gives you a space to stamp your greeting. And you could just do straight stamping like I'm going to do. You could put a sentiment strip in there, but it's a really lovely die with lots of detail. I will be using some of these tiny words birthday messages. There are a ton of birthday messages here, and I'm going to use just the simple have a fabulous birthday, but the tiny word set is really cool. Got some picked raspberry, carved pumpkin, mustard seed, and twisted citron for my ink blending, and I'm just using the jumbo sponge daubers because I really like how those work. For cardstock, I've got a couple different pieces of the Nina Solar White and some key lime from Gina K Designs. And I'm also going to be using some of Gina's embossing ink and some Brutus Monroe gilded powder. I've also got just a generic circle die from Hero Arts that I'm using. And of course, I will be stamping with my Misti tool, and that's about it. So let's get into it. Now this die, I just found a circle die that would fit around this because I wanted to trace a circle onto a panel that I've already cut. And I cut this panel, I think this one is 3.5 by 4.75, using one of my favorite die sets, which is called the A2 Layers die from Waffle Flower. And the reason I traced the circle is I wanted to make sure that when I ink blended, that I contained my rainbow within the bounds of the circle. Because I don't know about you, but sometimes when I get started on blending, if I'm not paying attention, I will make bands that are way too wide or that just don't fit the space. And that is the only reason I am doing it this way and having that circle down. It's just a guide so that I can blend my circle. And I went pretty heavy on this because this needs to show through the die cut circle. And so it doesn't have to be pretty, it's a little pretty, but it doesn't have to be perfect. The blend doesn't have to be perfect, thank you. Now, I cut this little strip of cardstock that I had, just a little scrap, because I was having a hard time lining up this die on my panel. And I found that by having that strip in the right place, even though there are dots on the back, I just couldn't get it lined up, but having a cardstock strip and using my cutting mat helped me to position that perfectly. And then I'm gonna go ahead and die cut this. Running it through the Spellbinders Platinum 6, and as I was pulling this off, here's the thing with purple tape. It works great for not sticking and tearing paper, but sometimes when you go through a die cut machine, it gets pressed down and it will create a bond that can mar your paper. So I had to erase a little bit of the left behind residue. I brought out my foam pad, and you can use a mouse pad for this, but just for these delicate dies, for poking out the little pieces, it works quickly. And now I'm taking a larger die. This is 3.75 by 5, also from that same die set, so that I can cut out my panel. All right, now just getting the sentiment lined up, placing it down. And I am using some embossing magic because I find that the embossing powder wants to stick everywhere, especially when you have these intricate dies. So powdered that up, used Gina's embossing ink, stamped it down. And now I'll just sprinkle on my embossing powder, just like that. And I tapped it off and I did realize, yeah, you're gonna have to bring the brush because it did stick in places that I didn't, you can't really see it here, but trust me, it's there. So if you have that errant powder, just bring in a dry brush. I have a dedicated brush for this. Or, I learned this from Laura Basson, you can use your craft pick to be really picky, right? And get in there and take out single grains. So you can always do that. Heat set, all shiny and melted and ready to go. I'm scoring my card base. This will be a top folding card, 5.5 tall by 4.25 wide. Give it a nice little press there with my bone folder. And as always, I tape my cards closed when I'm working on them. I really need them to be flat, especially when you're having a simple card with a margin surrounding your panel. Having it straight and looking straight down, very helpful. Thank you. I'll adhere this panel now with just some dot runner adhesive. And this is why I wanted to have it cut with the die, because I know for a fact if I frame this perfectly, right, that 3.5 by 4.75 piece is going to easily be hidden on the edges by the larger die that I cut this panel. One thing that I did is after I took all of the foam backing tape off, this die has these little like squirrely pop-ups, and you press them out and they can give a little bit of just cute frilly dimension just coming right out of the cardstock. So I just wanted to make sure those were free, and then just kind of play with it a bit, kind of bend it up and work my way around, and then boom, place that down with that beautiful key lime. And you can see how nice the key lime cardstock picks up on the twisted citron. And again, just coming in and, well, I'm zhuzhing, right? I'm just zhuzhing them up, just getting them up, making them look curly and poppy. And they'll probably get flattened in the mail, but it's still a cute detail. All right. Now, I did a second card. So the first one I thought, no, I really need that green. I really need the color. I didn't want to add anything else to this card, but then I had done it in white. I think that looks really good too. I'm kind of a sucker for all white cards, but either way, I got two birthday cards in the hopper, ready to go. Thanks so much for watching today. I would love to have you become a subscriber to my channel, and I'll see you back here with another card project soon.